And welcome back here again. I want to say a special thanks for joining me here again today. I hope you guys are all doing great. If you haven't subscribed yet, please, what are you waiting for? Just click on the red button and then that's all you need to do. Okay, if you have your phone with you and you are seeing a red button that says subscribe, it means you need to turn it gray by clicking on that button. And if it's gray already, it means you have already subscribed. Thank you so much, guys. So today, quickly, a follow up to a previous video that I made about rethinking or redefining single mother. I know I got a lot of calls, people calling me, but me, I don't understand my people. Why? I don't know where the comment section there. Okay, let me tell you, you see the video, when you listen to the video, to see the comment section, right? You just screw, you just say, screw up, screw up, screw up, screw up. Till you get to the very bottom, you will see the comment section. That's the best place now. My WhatsApp messages, my messengers full. People, I don't like, you sure, very soon I will stop replying, okay? If you want to make it interactive, just leave it in the comment section. It's as easy and peasy. Abi, you get who na they fear? Wait till na they hide. I bet my people. People will not even know you because your real name doesn't even seem to show when you even leave your comments there. That's the truth. So, guys, yeah, I receive a lot of feedback. They were quite interesting, but before we proceed further, I just want to clarify that video. It's like some of us don't understand. It's not like I don't say single mother don't exist. Single mother does exist. Yes, of course, if a woman is left alone with the sole responsibility of taking care of a child, the father is nowhere in the picture, like it's a deadbeat. He no dey any picture. You don't even need his signature to sign the passport of your child. Of course, you're a single mother. If your husband, if you're a widow, you are a single mother. I'm not to say no, they exist. They exist, but there are some circumstances, okay, that will not make you fit into that, you know, categorization of a single mother. If you are divorced, it doesn't mean you are a single mother, because there is also an ex-partner who is involved in the well-being of the child. It means you cannot just wake up one day and take the child and travel to Sierra Leone. There is somebody you will have to tell that, hey, Papa, Gabriel, we are going to Sierra Leone next week. Oh, you want to get a visa or a passport or something? He will need to sign. You want to say you are single? You are not single. You are not single because there's somebody actually that is also, partaking in the well-being, in the care of the child. That's what I'm trying to say. You are single means, you are single mother means you don't need anybody. Sure, nobody exists. Even though you go passport office, you have every proof that there is no other person, there's no partner, then you are a bona fide single mother. That is what I'm trying to say. It shows you how many of you are in that situation where you don't need a signature in a passport, it's just you alone. Anywhere you go, it's short. You just fit into that label, say, now only you and nobody else exist. Even they say they want to adopt that child tomorrow, they don't need to go and consult with any other person. That is a single mother. That is what I was trying to say. But you know what, I also work with adoption workers where you have to adopt a child. The father is saying no. The father who has not been anywhere before, as long as the father is alive, the child get father. The adoption workers want to hear his take, because that father can sue that adoption agency, for that matter, for not consulting with him. For crying out loud, I have worked with a mother who is here with her children, and the father of the children is in Saudi Arabia. They are not even on good terms. They are not together, but the woman is claiming that we are no longer together. Fine, we know you are not, but you are not a single mother, because this children has a father who actually wants to know everything about his children. I have to be calling Saudi Arabia like almost every other day, and this man was calling every other day, asking for the way. In short, all the way from Saudi Arabia, he paid the children's school fees here in Canada to make sure the children are in a good school. Do you think that woman fits into that profile of a single mother, even when they are no longer together? No, because there was a father. That is the point I was trying to make. Are we getting it? And if you are a woman and you feel you are doing so much for your child, you do it. Now you the bath and go school. In one quarter, you won't do everything. Father, now every time they show. Are they very sorry? You know, still a single mother. Because the papa dead there, you understand? That 10% when they do so, for an big thing they do. if it cause any trouble tomorrow, anything can happen. No, you know, I know I'm a woman myself, but the truth has to be told. I'm not saying that it's not possible to be a single mother, but you don't fit into that profile when there is still a father there who is still doing something, who you still need, who the government can still sometimes call on and say, you know what, we want to confirm something. If the government does not need to confirm anything, you don't need the signature, then yes, go ahead, you're a single mother. So what I meant by single woman on the other hand is that, you know, this woman is like, now my life first, I don't care about the children. Do what you have to do, take the children, go anywhere, you know, because I mean, I get my own life. Now that one, I be single woman. You just want to be free. Okay, that is why this video is made to even teach us sense. Come on, I mean, teach your sense that, you know what, before you even think of having a child, be careful who you have children with. Be very careful, because once you have a child or children together, once a family is always a family. You know that? Once you have children together, there is something that is joining you together. No running, no escape. Even the damn man turn to wear it tomorrow for street. Too bad. That's so it be. You understand? That's why you have to be very careful. Not be saying you just open leg buy. Then the next thing, a baby material, you go to buy. Not be like that. Once you don't get that picking together, even the man run away, go Cameroon, he go anywhere. Who is this? I'm sorry, guys. For real? I'm sorry, guys. So even the man go Cameroon, he go anywhere. As long as he's not dead, he can show up anytime. You're not the single mother, okay? You are not taking all the decisions. You are not taking 100 decisions for the child. You are not a single mother. But if you are taking 99% of decisions and somebody is there taking one decision of it, 1% of the decisions, you're not the single mother, okay? That's what I was trying to say, okay? You are a single mother when not just you and the picking or the children, no other person. Then that one a single mother. Am I clear now? Because I know the kind of questions, the kind of feedback I was getting really showed that people do not understand this. So I have to come here and clarify. And because of this time now, we actually have something that we are supposed to talk about today. But because I have to clarify this now, this one sort of take most of the time. And I don't want to be making this video too long. Because once it becomes too long, people are bored and people are like, I'm always working, I don't get time. So I want to make sure when you start watching this video, you are able to finish it. Not say you watch and reach half and along the way, you just fall asleep. So that's why I really need to clarify this. And what I really wanted to talk about today was something I saw on Facebook, like as to the question if you can be friends with an ex-partner. I mean, from what we have been saying about single mother, single parent, balance, I mean, do you think that will really help? By, okay, if you don't have kids together, that's one thing. You're just lovers and something happened and didn't work out. And you think you have every reason to isolate that partner, like that partner is now your enemy because things doesn't work out. That's a big mistake now. You should even be happy because maybe it was never meant to be. There are people who can be good lovers, but they cannot be good husband and wife. That in terms of relationship, boyfriend, I go, kiss me, I kiss you, they are very good. But when it comes to living together as husband and wife, they may not be the best material. So if they realize this and the pathway ASAP, is that a bad thing? Should that make them enemies? Do you know where they are going to meet tomorrow? Do you know where their children are going to meet? Anyway, we'll not dwell on that too much now. Because this one, now about family, we'll talk about. Let's assume they have children together. And because they are now exes, they're not going to be friends again. Eh? If the children, they graduate, they're not be friends. So they don't have to invite any other. They don't have to invite each other. Or rather, let's say they're in that graduation party. There will be enemies for them. They're not going to talk to each other. They're not going to be friends. No love lost. No smile. Nothing. Who not this one that they do? Now embarrassment for the child now. Like I attended one wedding where you can just see the man was even trying to be mature, behave. I don't know whoever was the cause of the breakup, but I want to believe maybe it's the man. Now sometimes it's even the woman that break the relationship up and then things not come work out. Now you go see the verse. Eh? Now you break relationship up, now you see the verse. Why? Why it will be like that? If you break relationship up, you find your way. Whether anything will happen for that side, you take him. You don't need to come the verse again for somebody who will be saying, now you victimized, now you dumb. Anyway, long story short, this man was happy in the wedding. Everything was okay. The woman was all the time. Ah, I said, since on a wedding, any people they behave like this, so there was no point for that in a wedding. What statement is that woman already establishing? What foundation is that woman already establishing in that marriage? That is why all the women they do wedding, women are they very careful the kind of people you invite. Are you for real? Who is this? I'm sorry, guys. You guys should be very careful the kind of people you invite to your wedding. Because all these exes with their drama and all that, when you bring it to your wedding, you know what made the angels grab that ugly faces and go transfer onto that wedding that's supposed to be happily ever after marriage. Oh. Anyway, I don't want to go into all that today. I don't want to digress. So what I'm saying, I don't think it makes sense to say because people are exes, they shouldn't be friends, they should be enemies. And in this round, this small world that we live in today, that somebody you met here today, in the next year, you don't know where you people are going to meet. Then you can't say and be enemies. Anyway, there's not much time to dwell on this, but I don't think it's a smart thing to think in the first place. Okay, guys? So I think we just end this here briefly, and then I'm going to come up again with another interesting topic next week. And if you like this video, whatever you think, please give it a thumbs up and leave your comments there. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Just click on the red button and get subscribed and stay tuned for more videos. Thanks for watching, guys. I remain your one and only Miss Continental. Stay blessed.